Welcome back everyone to theCUBE's live coverage here in Orlando, Florida for Qlik Connect 2025. I'm John Furrier, host of theCUBE with Bob Laliberte from theCUBE Research, bringing down all the data, bringing you all the stories. Kennie Greagen's here. She's the Applied Research and Innovation Manager at Foodbank Victoria. Julie Kae, VP of Sustainability and Executive Director at Qlik.org. Great story here on the use of data to make things more efficient. Thanks for coming on theCUBE, appreciate you.
Thanks for having me.
So first of all, let's tell a story, set the table, Qlik.org and your relationship. Talk about the partnership real quick and we'll get into the conversation.
So we have partnered with Qlik through a company called Notitia for the last 7 years or so. I've worked at Foodbank for 4 years and we basically have partnered with Qlik since then. So the way we work with Qlik is it's embedded in our daily work environment. Everybody in the organization is using it. We've got a handful of developers and we're basically just trying to make delivering food to the community easier, faster, and smoother.
It sounds easy, but there's a lot of problems. share the problem, scope the problem that you guys are addressing and how the data is kind of infused in to make it more efficient and more productive.
So some of the main challenges that we have in delivering food to our communities are we receive the food often quite short dated. So 70% of our stock is donated to us from manufacturers, growers, supermarkets. And often it'll come into the warehouse needing to go straight back out of the warehouse because otherwise it won't be good for consumption. So we use data to understand as well as we can what we've got coming in and how quickly we need to move it so that we can prioritize based on how fast the food needs to go out to actually get it to the community through our partners so that it is useful.
And if you don't do that, it's wasted. You got to carry it, you got to dispose it, so that you're under a clock, essentially.
That's exactly right. And since we started using Qlik to understand how we could move the food and move it quickly, we've been able to drop our waste to under 1%.
Okay, give an example of data in action, because this is the whole concept of the show here. We've been talking about is dashboards to decision engines seems to be the theme. Decisions meaning, you know your decisions, get it out fast.
Yeah.
What examples can you share? Because I think this is a really acute case of value, right? So can you share how Qlik's being used? What's happened with it? And without it, what would it be like?
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the pieces of work that we've done in Qlik over the last 2 years or so is to basically map our community to understand where the greatest pockets of need are and who are the people in those communities that we're serving. We have quite a diverse community in Melbourne, and so we need to ensure that we've got the right food for people. One of our biggest values is to provide food relief with dignity. And so that a part of that is understanding who the food is going to so that we can make sure that we've got culturally appropriate food. So we use data from all kinds of external sources, the government, schools, charity partners, and use that to map who the people are that the food is going to so that we can then make sure that our charity partners are able to get the right food. That drives our procurement program. So effectively, the 30% of stock that we purchase is purchased based on the data that we've got about our community and the data that we've got about the stock that we've got in our warehouse, some predictive modeling to understand what we might have coming in so that we know what we need to buy to kind of top up that food offering.
Can you talk about the Qlik side, because Qlik.org, this is not a your business financial services company. This is like a real mission critical mission.
Absolutely.
Talk about the role you guys are playing and what you're seeing on your side, because they're embedded. They're instrumenting running their operation.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, so Qlik has supported organizations like Foodbank Victoria for, you know, since, you know, our inception and actually in a kind of a programmatic way as Qlik.org for over 15 years. And what we see within kind of the nonprofit sector is an incredible need for technology, one, right, to better leverage data so that they can serve their beneficiaries faster, more efficiently, less waste, all of that, but have very common problems to all of Qlik's customers, right? And there's data in different silos that you want to bring together, you need to do it quickly, you need to make decisions, you need to prioritize, and nonprofits that we work with are doing all of that under a significant amount of time sensitivity, right? We work with a number of humanitarian aid organizations, one in particular, Direct Relief, out of California, responding to the refugee crisis when Ukraine was invaded, and used data to understand where refugees were going so that they could get their medical supplies on the ground to help those people upon arrival, right? So these organizations are under so much pressure to help people save lives, provide, you know, food, you know, kind of lessen the vulnerabilities, if you will, of certain citizens, and through data can just drive that mission forward. Yeah, so we're proud to support them.
that sounds great. One of the big themes, obviously, in the keynote this morning, there was obviously a lot of talk about AI, generative AI, agentic AI. I wonder if you could comment on your use of it today in whatever form or fashion, and then moving forward, how you feel like, or what maybe some of the early use cases you want to apply it to?
Yeah, we're actually at the very, very beginning of our AI journey, being a relatively small organization. So we've kind of just gone through the exercise of working out what some potential use cases are and how we could use AI in all kinds of different forms. So we're looking at things like advanced analytics, which, I mean, it's a no-brainer with the tools that we've got. But we're also looking at tools that will allow our food donors a more pleasant experience in donating to us. At the moment, it's quite challenging. They email our sourcing team with the information of what they would like to donate, and then there's a fair bit of back and fro to try and organize it. So we're looking at developing an intelligent AI solution that will actually do it all automatically.
Have your agents talk to their agents.
Correct.
Right.
Exactly, yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Kennie, we had two sessions so far today that kind of brought up a theme, and I'll just want to ask you about it, because one was the Women Who Qlik. There's a big event tonight, 5 o'clock around Women Who Qlik, and the conversation was about, you don't need to know about the databases and be a nerd to take advantage of what you guys are now doing with the Qlik. And the other one was on the partner side, there's a lot of new partners in your channels that don't have to be super experts at serverless and writing Python code. And here, the third one here is like, you don't need to have the big budgets. There's a lot of democratization, so to speak, but also access to the technology and the application. So NGOs, nonprofits, impact organizations are pretty thin at the top, but they put all their resources to the mission. And businesses have that same philosophy. So I want to ask you is that this is the trend. You don't need to know the databases. So how do you see this mission continuing? Because this gives organizations that don't have the resources, could be public sector, could be areas that don't have the massive IT budgets, but have data.
Right.
And don't need to be like a data scientist, like whiz to do it. What's your reaction to that?
Right.
And what does that mean to the market?
Yeah, no, great question. I mean, so as kind of part of our programming, we've offered discounted and or free software and services to organizations who are serving that kind of mission. Recognizing that, you know, people are very generous, organizations are very generous, but people also want to know that their donation or their support is going to the people in need. Yeah. And that then ends up in this kind of environment whereby organizations that are serving those people in need aren't necessarily able to invest in themselves. And so kind of programs like ours, along with other technology companies and our partners, of course, that have worked with Foodbank Victoria, recognize that, and just it's part of kind of our give back program. So we feel that our employees kind of want to get engaged. They want to support organizations. They want to leverage their skills to give back. And organizations like ours want to step in and support with our, you know, our assets, again, so that we can all live healthier lives.
Yeah. So, Julie, that obviously a great mission, that what you're doing. If we've got people watching out there who are part of an organization, how do they get involved? How do they get, you know, give a plug for Qlik.org and how organizations should reach out to you if they're interested in working like the relationship you have here with
Certainly.
Victoria
Food Bank. So yeah, visit us at www.qlik.org and to learn more about how these programs kind of work and exist. And we have several use cases, examples of some other partners doing great work like Foodbank Victoria to kind of learn and see if that type of need exists within your organization that we can support and partner together.
Yeah, I would assume that virtually all organizations like yours have a need for technology to overcome a lack of physical resources to be able to do them, and that we were just talking with James, your chief strategy officer, and is it G2, Ritu from IDC, and talking about the agents and whether they were a digital workforce or digital laborers. But that's certainly the more you can leverage something like that, having people doing tasks for you that you don't have to dedicate your own time is going to provide a lot of efficiencies back to you to work on more strategic initiatives, maybe reaching more people, right? Greater reach. So I wonder if you could maybe just comment on that a little bit about, I know you're just starting the journey on AI, but how you're thinking about, how do you get there faster and what's your time to comfort with that technology?
And I think it's so important to be able to automate and use AI in any way that we can. And it is because most charities, we are resource constrained. financially, people, all everything. So being able to do things in better ways, more efficiently, as you said, just allows us to have the time to look at more valuable activity. So I think while we are really early in the journey of AI, it goes back to our data journey as well. Simply understanding the food that we've got and the product that we've got available and expect to have available to us. Before we had Qlik and this data was really difficult. Yeah. So the team would spend significant amounts of time trying to figure out what we needed, to talk to partners, to talk to manufacturers, to ask for the donations that we needed. Whereas now, pun not intended, it's a click of a button.
Yeah. So the old way was a lot of time wasted, what? Weeks, months, just planning?
Yeah, absolutely.
So the throughput on productivity is what, 10x?
At least, yeah, absolutely.
Huge. Value.
Absolutely, and we're growing so fast. Like the demand in Melbourne or in Victoria for food relief is huge. Like we're distributing 25 million meals a year, and that just grows every year. So being able to find that productivity and bring that back so that our team can be focusing on the really valuable added stuff that they're doing now.
It's a sustainability story and it's a humanity story.
Absolutely. Yeah.
It's both in one.
Yes.
And you guys must
And she's even launching, you should talk about your food literacy programs. They're even launching food literacy programs in schools.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, so we've actually already got a cooking classes program in our schools. So we run a school breakfast program that goes out to about 1,200 schools. We'll be at 1,400 by the end of the year. And so we run cooking classes programs through those educational facilities. They're currently targeted at the school kids and their families. So they're reaching people who have, maybe don't speak English as their first language, maybe don't understand how to cook with Western food, and teaching them how to cook and how to cook healthy food options. And we're at the moment piloting a proof of concept in one of our regional centres to actually expand that out to adults.
It's like what they're saying here in the Qlik teams, get the data at the right place at the right time. You're an application of that, that's the product.
Yeah.
And otherwise it's wasted time spent and the output's not there. This is a great win for Qlik.org. Take a minute to explain what you guys are working on. You mentioned some other projects.
Yeah.
Julie, to explain kind of the scope of Qlik.org for the folks who may not know what you're working on.
Yeah, so certainly. So like I said, we support hundreds of NGOs around the world. Very proud to support organizations like the United Nations Secretariat, the World Health Organization, as well as NGOs in various countries who are working in the areas of either climate change, disaster relief, humanitarian aid, global health, or education. And again, it's about data. It's about equipping these organizations with the power of technology to leverage data, and specifically kind of the unique features of Qlik of bringing disparate data together so that they can make sense of it, reach more people faster, and get that support where it's needed most. And so we like the big, hairy challenges. The more complex, the better, because that usually means a lot of different data needs to come together to understand it and understand what the solution could be. And so we love those projects.
You know, tech for good is a theme that's near and dear to our heart. Most people think, oh, the big bad tech companies, but in impact, where you have supply chain, humanitarians, tech's involved, the data, it's the data. It's not like a tech thing, it's a data thing.
Yeah.
So data talk thing. About that. Tech for good. There's a lot of tech companies that are early adopters joining up with missions.
Yes.
Philanthropy missions, impact investing. Kind of a cultural change. Could you share your thoughts on that? Because we're seeing action there.
Right. Well, it's a cultural change, but it's also very personal for people.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I have people, colleagues that support organizations that are finding homes for animals, to kind of food relief or food insecurity, to climate change, to cancer research, what have you. So like people want to give back. They want to do good in the world. They want to have a purpose. They want to have a mission.
Yeah.
And by equipping organizations with technology so that they can leverage their data to further their mission, we're also kind of working with all our colleagues so that they feel like their skills can be put to use to kind of fuel their passion and support their purpose. And so it's just a really exciting kind of way to bring a bunch of data people together with nonprofits and missions to really define and fulfill that purpose.
Okay. Now, so quick question for you. I mean, given your unique view and of all the organizations that you work with, do you have separate events to get those organizations together to better learn how to leverage their data more effectively and be able to sponsor that?
I'd love to. We do go to a lot of events like Climate Week in New York or the UN General Assembly, the annual climate conference in the fall, as well as there's some NGO conferences that take place that we do and kind of talk about our solutions so that, again, others can learn from that, share their experiences, and we can all get farther together.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely, that's great.
Julie Kae, thank you for coming on theCUBE. Love your mission. Congratulations on success. Data's at the heart of all the problems. Now for humanity, not just for productivity in business. Thanks for coming on, appreciate it.
Thanks for having us.
theCUBE, I'm John Furrier with Bob Laliberte. We'll be back after this short break.